What's up, you guys? Coachella Reefer here. If you guys are familiar with the products I'll be using in this video, feel free to fast forward it. I will be showing almost every single step of the process for new reefers starting to get in the hobby. So feel free to fast forward if you guys get a little bored. Today we will be building a phosguard reactor-ish. And I've actually never used phosguard, but a friend of mine told me it works pretty good. So this is actually the first time I'm trying it out. The directions are pretty simple. It says use 1/3 of a cup for every 50 US gallons for salt water and 100 it says use 400 mil for every 100 US gallons for fresh water. But I'm using it for salt water, so I'll be using the 1/3 of a cup for the 50 gal. And we will start opening this thing. As you guys can see, I got the small one. They actually sell bigger containers, but this is pretty much good for about, I don't know, I think it will last like about 6 months or so, because the tank I will be using it, it's basically a 55 gallon, but with all the life rock that it has in it, it's basically a 50 gallon. As you guys can see, there are the pellets. They're pretty small. So there's 1/3 of a cup. Let's add this thing. Nice and slow. So yeah, guys, this just depends on the volume of water you have in your tanks. So let's shake it a little bit and see the exact measurement. I don't think it has to be the exact measurement. Some people use more than recommended or less than recommended, but I almost all the time I use the recommended, to be honest, guys. I'm not saying it's the best thing to do, but that's just how I use the stuff I buy. And in the directions, it will say to rinse it out. Like, it doesn't say exactly how much you're supposed to rinse it, but I'm starting to rinse this like pretty much until the water is clear. It took me like about 5 minutes to rinse it out. The water turned pretty cloudy, so I did take a while rinsing it out. All right, guys, so this is my reactor-ish. I decided to use this plastic bottle. Like I told you guys, this will be a cheap build, a DIY. You guys will notice that I do like a lot of budget stuff. I'll be using this tool set I bought it at a hardware store for 10 bucks, you guys. I use this pretty much like a lot. I use it to frag corals. I use it to drill holes and stuff. It's pretty handy and cheap. All right, so I will add the holes on the bottle. There it is, you guys. I drilled holes for the water to circulate all the way to the bottom. That was made with the Dremel tool that I just showed you guys. It's a pretty cheap tool and nice to have, pretty handy. we will be cutting this part of the bottle. Look, now I use the disc to cut it. Yeah, guys, that tool comes in handy a lot. The best $10 I spent. You guys can like sand this thing down, or I don't know. I'll just leave it like that. All right, guys, so the next thing you will need, it's a filter floss. I have this piece left over from another tank I have. Yeah, pretty much just use as much as you need for the bottom. This will be covering up the little holes on the bottom so that the little pellets don't go through. I will rinse this out because it's dirty. Second ingredient, the phosguard pellets. Let's add them inside the little container. Make sure you guys spread them like equally, so you get the nice coverage. This reactor pretty much works with almost any type of media, guys. This is basically an experiment of mine. Actually, not an experiment because I've seen it before, but you guys pretty much can like add whichever media you guys want. This thing will work pretty nice. What I'm adding right now, it's activated carbon and detoxifier. Those little green rocks are detoxifying. So I will be adding a little bit of filter floss on top just to make sure the media doesn't get out. And this is pretty much the finished product, you guys. It looks pretty cheap, but it will do an amazing job. I guarantee you that. Feel free to leave a comment for questions. I can answer any question for the beginners or whichever questions you guys have. Leave them in the comments, please. And let me know if you want me to do any other DIYs. So I'll be placing this right where the return of the skimmer is. There it is, you guys. Nice and ready. I can tell that it's working because it's bubbling from the bottom. As you can see, the little bubbles. That's pretty much it, guys. Make sure to leave a comment and subscribe. Like the video or unlike the video if you want. Either way, thank you very much for watching the video. If you are watching it until this part, have a nice day, you guys. More DIYs videos coming up.